Today I'm going to make a mallet, and the first job is to glue these blocks together. I have got some wood that would be big enough to make the head in one go, but I really want to make it out of white oak. When the glue's dry, I'll put it on the lathe and turn it round, and then I'm going to fit a steel ring either side of the head. I'm going to make the rings with this mild steel. It's 25mm by 3mm. There's no reason for doing this. I'm just trying to add some texture and give it that forged look. And I cleaned it up first so I can see any flat spots where I miss with the ball peen hammer. I'm going to form this into a ring using my specialised bending equipment, a small weight and a vise. Before I turn the head, I'm going to make the handle, and I'm also going to do that out of white oak. I did a great job at getting a nice fit, but I made a big mistake as well. That happened because I was rushing. I was rushing because I wanted to get the video done today because I'm going to be busy for a couple of days. I wasn't thinking. I grabbed the head to mark how far I needed to make this tenant, and I put it that way, which was very stupid. What was I thinking? But it needed obviously to go that way. The obvious thing to do would be to turn a new handle, but I haven't got a piece of white oak wide enough without gluing two bits together, and I don't really want to do that. It is only a little bit shorter than what I was aiming for. It's 28 centimeters and I was aiming at 30, so I could just live with it, but that couple of centimeters I think would make a difference, and it feels a little bit short. I could glue a collar here, but not sure how good that would look. What I am going to do is extend the handle. I'm going to turn a tenon on the end here. I've got this piece of black wattle. I've already drilled a hole through there. I'm going to glue that on and extend it. And that's a nice grip size at the end of the handle. And I think it should actually turn out quite nice. I'm just putting a couple of grooves in to relieve any glue that gets stuck in the bottom of the hole. They don't have to be neat, but as long as it goes from one end to the other, it will do its job. I want the handle to be more oval because I think that would be a better fit in the hand. So I've started by putting a flat on either side and I'll just start shaping it over until it just feels right all the way down. That's the handle done, now it's time to move on to the head, and the handle actually turned out very, very nice. I'm really pleased with that. The next job is to put the steel rings on, but I have to chop this off just so I can have a proper look and post a progress shot on Instagram. I was going to heat the rings up so they expanded, fit them over the mallet head, and then they contract and get a very nice tight fit. My problem is I've got my little forge here that I built a while back and the rings don't fit in there, so I can't do that. And I don't think I'd get them hot enough with the blowtorch. So what I've done instead is I've got a nice tight fit. They just go over the edge, but they'll need hammering on. I'm going to epoxy it, hammer them on, and then drill and nail them as well. So I'm pretty sure they'll still be tight enough. And by the way, in the next couple of weeks, I'm going to build a proper forge as well. So look out for that video. I've just made a couple of saw cuts in the end of the handle, and when that's fitted into the head and wedged, it won't come out. And to make it even stronger, I use the reamer to open up this one end. So when that is wedged, it's going to spread this and there's no way that should be able to pull back out. I reckon that turned out great. I'm very, very happy with it and I love the handle, so I'm sort of glad I made that mistake. It's a big hefty thing. I'm not really sure how much I'd ever use it, but it'll look cool on the wall and I'm sure I will use it at some point as well. The reason I made it so big is I couldn't find anything smaller than this weight that was substantial enough to bend around. I did think about cutting a piece of hardwood and maybe that would have worked, but I was happy enough to go with something a bit bigger. But maybe if I were to do it again, I might. This is 100 mil. I'd probably go down to 90 mil. But anyway, I love it. So hopefully you enjoyed it too. If you did, please like and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.